Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. This is Sandra and I make videos about cybersecurity as well as tech careers. And in today's video, in honor of the start of 2022, I wanted to cover the topic of how to get a job in cybersecurity in 2022. So without going into reasons about why a cybersecurity job is super fulfilling and also very well paid and has great job security, it is expected that there are going to be about 3.5 million job openings for cybersecurity roles by 2025. So obviously it is a very well demanded job with skill sets and knowledge that employers are actively looking for and really trying to fill. So whether you have no technical background at all, have graduated from a bootcamp, even have your bachelor's or master's degree, or are switching into cybersecurity from another career path, there are so many reasons to go into cybersecurity. And in today's video, I'll be going over all the ways you can set yourself up to get that first cybersecurity job. Okay, so the first thing I wanted to discuss in this video is the fact that most cybersecurity experience you can actually get for free on the World Wide Web, specifically using tools like Hack the Box, Try Hack Me, different Capture the Flag Challenge walkthrough guides, cyber news, hacking articles. There's so many guides and walkthroughs and resources out there. If you wanted to learn how to use a tool like Burp Suite or Metasploit, there are hours and hours of a free video training that you can find right on YouTube, and you don't have to pay a course to get the skills needed to learn those tools. Don't go and spend $50 or $100 on a course that is going to teach you how to use a tool when you can essentially learn it for free through guides and video tutorials. And in my personal opinion, I don't believe that you should be paying for resources unless you are going into something really niche or you're studying for a certification with niche material. But if it's something like learning how to hack, understanding what SQL injection is, understanding how to detect and fix cross-site scripting, different things like that, you can honestly find on YouTube. And I really do think that free resources are just as good as paid for resources. And when you're starting out, you always want to go the cheapest route possible. For example, if you wanted to go into pen testing or red teaming, then as a complete beginner, you can really start with the Hack the Box challenges. And Hack the Box and Try Hack Me are basically websites where you can basically practice hacking and really understand what it is like to be on a red team or doing some kind of security assessment in an actual real life setting. And again, there are plenty of free guides and walkthroughs out there that people have written up on various different cybersecurity blogs. And that was also how I got started. So I didn't pay for any hacking courses. I basically just did Capture the Flags. As a beginner, I didn't know where to start, so I would read people's notes and I would understand what they're doing, how they're thinking, how they knew how to use certain tools. And it really just comes with experience. So that's why you really want to get that free experience first on these websites. And many of the tools that are used in cybersecurity organizations are also open source, which means they're free to use, or they have some kind of community edition or a free edition for people who want to use it and test it out. Obviously, it won't have all of the fun features, but you can still use it to do many different things. For example, if you wanted to use Burp Suite, you can use the community edition, or you could use the Zed Attack Proxy or ZAP, which is kind of just as good for beginner learning purposes. And by the way, if you guys are also interested, I have a video linked below on the highest paid entry level roles in cybersecurity if you guys want to check that out after this video. All right, so after you take advantage of all the free resources, whether it's free courses to learn different tools, completing Hack the Box challenges, doing your own practice on websites like the DVWA, which is a site that is out there, which is purposely vulnerable to threats and attacks, and it's basically out there for people to use to test their hacking skills. Obviously, do not go and hack google.com. You will get into a bit of trouble if you do that. So with that, I do want to go into the resume part of this video. So with all the things that you learned, you can put all of those into personal projects, technical and cyber experience, additions into your skills and tools section of your resume. Maybe you took some free MOOCs or massive online courses, which basically are provided by a bunch of different schools in the US, including Ivy Leagues. And by the way, MOOCs are completely free. And after you complete them, you can put them on your resume. And I really think it beefs up your resume more than even a online certification program might. There are also free certification programs that you can do online to add to your resume. Even if it's a beginner certification, it's honestly better than nothing, because when I was applying for my first cybersecurity job, the only thing cybersecurity above my resume was that I had a certification in computer security and digital forensics from my university. It is not an internationally recognized certification. It's just something that my school had. And as a student, I was able to take advantage of it by taking two or three extra classes. But having that on my resume was a talking point, you know, during cybersecurity interviews, if I went to a career fair, if I went to a meetup for networking, then that was always something I could bring up. And it also just helps to get your foot in the door. So even if it's not a internationally acclaimed certification, it doesn't matter. It really shows that you're taking the initiative to do those things, even as someone who is a beginner or just coming into cybersecurity. So resumes obviously are very important. They get your foot in the door, and they're also step zero to what a recruiter or someone actually sees about who you are. So you definitely wanted to reflect positively on all of the experience that you've gotten so far. And by the way, I also have my resume linked below in my career resources website if you guys want to check that out as well. There you can find anything from my resume to my cover letter to interview prep as well as career plans. Alright, so now after your resume is looking spiffy and you added all that experience that you've just gained from free resources that you found online or various different online courses or certification programs, now let's go into the actual job hunt. So if you're anything like me, this is the part that really gets me nervous because I am definitely not a natural interviewer. I get really, really anxious, especially when it comes to technical interviews. And as someone who is going into cybersecurity, you are definitely going to expect some technical cybersecurity questions. And I want to add that I had previously made a video on cybersecurity interview prep, and I can link that down below if you guys are interested. So I won't go into the depths of what to actually study for interviews since I covered all of this in that video. But one thing to note for the job search is that the most important thing, honestly, is getting your numbers out there. So I know people who have applied to 10 jobs and got rejected from all of them, or even worse, or just never even heard back from them. That is honestly what you're gonna see in most jobs that you apply for, very sadly. And they honestly don't even give you a reason if they reject you either. So I definitely think that's a big downside in the hiring search, because honestly, when you apply to 10, 20 jobs and you don't hear back from any of them, or you get an automatic rejection, which I have gotten many, many times, it really gets your spirits down as well as your self-confidence when it comes to finding a job. But what I'm telling you right now is that you need to apply to hundreds and hundreds of roles. When I was applying to jobs out of college, I was probably applying to over 100, 200 jobs, and in total, I had less than 3 offers. And that is honestly a lot. And even then, I thought I had a pretty strong resume. I thought I had a pretty decent GPA and pretty relevant work experience. But some employers, you know, you might just not be what they're looking for, and that's okay. And that's why you want to cast a very wide net for the roles that you apply to. And don't just look on one website, look on multiple, whether it's the Google Jobs website, Indeed, Monster.com, Built-In NYC, or the whole Built-In series that has a bunch of jobs, that has a bunch of tech jobs for startups and smaller companies. So this isn't a comprehensive list, but it's definitely great places to start. And of course, another good way to start is making a list of the top companies that you want to apply to, and then going on their actual career websites to look for jobs in cybersecurity. And don't worry when the job application says you need 5 years of experience, because honestly, that is not true. Sure, there may be companies that see your resume and say, no, 5 years of experience, then you're off the list. But 80% of companies are not going to do that. If you have the experience, if you have the tools listed and skills that you're looking for based on the actual job qualifications that they're looking for, then I would still apply, especially if it's a company that you really want. Most companies list out the tools that they're using in their cybersecurity teams. So you can actually take the top 3 or 4 of those that you see. And if those tools are open source or free to use, you can do some research on them, try to use them hands-on in your personal laptop or machine, maybe do a few beginner projects on them, and then add that to your resume. And now your resume makes you look like the perfect candidate for exactly what that company is looking for. So obviously this would be really time consuming if you're doing this for every single job that you're applying to, but I would specifically do that for the top 3 or 5 jobs or companies that you really, really want to work for. And then everything else is cast a wide net, apply to hundreds and hundreds of job applications, and don't do it just on LinkedIn, because I know LinkedIn makes it really easy to just one click apply, but I do think something that LinkedIn is really good for is making connections. Now again, you don't want to do this with every single company because it will take a very, very long time. But for LinkedIn, let's say there are 10 to 15 jobs that you're really interested in, or companies that you're really interested in. You have the whole LinkedIn network at your fingertips. You can easily find someone who is working in the same position that you want to be in, or the same company that you want to join, or even a recruiter from that company that is hiring for technical or security roles. There's nothing stopping you from reaching out, connecting with them, learning more about their company, understanding the candidates that they're looking for, what they value most in a candidate, and what they're looking for on a resume, and really just make it conversational. You obviously don't want to start off the conversation with, hey, I applied to this role, when can I hear back, you know? You don't want to say something so blatantly like asking them a favor, but what you're really trying to do is building rapport, which means that you're basically trying to build a professional connection, and maybe you like some of their posts on articles that they've written or posts that they've shared, and now all of a sudden this person is no longer a random person on LinkedIn. They're now your warm connection and someone you can actually reach out to for questions or maybe advice. I've heard many, many times of people who have reached out for one-on-ones from people that they've met on LinkedIn that really inspire them, so there really is no harm in reaching out to professionals professionals on LinkedIn that you would like to connect with, especially if they're in roles that you want to be in. You want to know their stories, their background, how they got to where they are, because that's where you want to be in a few years or later on in your career. But while you're doing this, if you do get people that are kind of giving you the cold shoulder, or maybe aren't responding to you, or maybe they just say no, then that's okay. Don't take those things personally. I reach out to many people on LinkedIn and I don't expect, you know, 100% of people to respond back to me. And I don't hold anything against them for that, because obviously people are very busy. If they're working a full-time job, then they likely have a lot on their plate and they may not even have seen your message. But you also don't want it to discourage you, because you still never know when or which connection you're going to make is going to help you open the door to find that new job, find that new mentor, maybe even find a new career path that you've never heard of. So basically the world is a big place, and let's say someone does say no to you or does reject you. If you think about it logically, it makes no difference in your life, because previously they were not helping you, and after you asked and they say no, they still aren't helping you. So really nothing has changed if they weren't helping you in the first place and they still aren't. So I wouldn't let that get to you. So if you think about it that way, it really helps put into perspective that, you know, it doesn't really make a difference. Yeah, basically don't let it get you down. All right, so we've covered how to get that free experience in cybersecurity, updating your resume, the actual job search, as well as the interview process, which I mentioned I discuss a lot more in depth in the interview prep video. So now let's go into certifications and boot camps. So I already mentioned earlier in this video that I do believe that you can get free certifications without having to get something universally acclaimed like the A+ or the Security Plus, which are very, very popular certifications for entry-level cybersecurity. So yes, there are free certifications out there that you can get online, and they will still make your resume look good. But of course, there are popular certifications out there for a reason, and I'm going to use the example of Security Plus because that is the one that I took when I was in my first year in my cybersecurity job. So I actually got this certification when I already started my job in cybersecurity, and I can link a video on how I passed my Security Plus in the box below. So while I do think that a certification isn't necessarily required to get an entry-level role in cybersecurity, I do think that the number one thing that the Security Plus certification at least has helped me the most is in terms of my interviewing skills. So when you think about it, the Security Plus has a very, very wide breadth of knowledge that you probably wouldn't even get in a college course. It just covers so many different things. For example, cryptography is one of the sections. I believe it's one out of 7 or 8 sections in the Security Plus exam. But in most colleges, cryptography might be a full semester course, which is why going for a entry-level certification could be really helpful in terms of your interviewing skills. Because as someone who has sat in on more beginner level cybersecurity interviews, a lot of them are really around high level topics that I've actually learned directly from studying for my Security Plus exam. And I took that exam a bit more than a year ago, and that information is still fresh in my mind because it really just sticks with you and helps you at least understand foundational cybersecurity topics at a high level. So that would be my main reason for recommending you guys to get an actual entry-level certification that is the Security Plus or equivalent. And in terms of bootcamps, I do think that there are many, many bootcamp options out there, especially for cybersecurity. I've seen so many cybersecurity bootcamps, and I don't necessarily have a specific one that is my favorite since I can't speak from experience as I haven't been part of a bootcamp. But I do have a video on coding and security bootcamps and their actual job prospects based on actual job statistics that I can link below if you guys are interested in checking that out after this video. But bootcamps are a great way to really get hands-on experience. So if you're someone who needs that accountability and that structure to be in a program and be learning with other students, or having a teacher or a teaching assistant who is helping you with certain assignments or giving you one-on-one guidance, then I would definitely go the bootcamp route, because while it isn't necessarily hand-holding, it definitely is a bit more guided, and you have an actual curriculum to follow that someone has created specifically for cybersecurity, and you won't just be pulling and reading a bunch of different videos and articles that may not be relevant to the role that you actually want to go into. So yeah, it all depends what kind of learner you are and whether you know exactly what role you want to go into, coding languages or skills you want to use on the job. Both of those things could be pricey, specifically the bootcamp, which can cost hundreds to thousands of dollars. So it's definitely a big investment, and I wouldn't pay for a bootcamp unless you're 100% sure that you want to go into cybersecurity. And if you could find a bootcamp that is more niche in the area of security that you actually want to go into, then that's even better. For example, SOC analyst or digital forensics or malware prevention. Those are all very niche areas in cybersecurity that will teach you the more niche tools that you may need in those jobs. And the last thing I wanted to discuss today is networking. So if you guys have been following along with my channel or watched any of my other videos talking about cybersecurity careers, then you know I got my first cybersecurity job, the one that I'm currently in, from a conference. So conferences are just big career fairs, essentially, and companies hire from them directly. Sometimes they interview on site for job openings that they have. So one of the best ways to get your foot in the door and get in front of a recruiter physically, and not just, you know, a digital copy of your resume on an online job portal, you definitely want to go to a conference or some kind of local career fair. So these are awesome places to meet people in the field that you want to go into, specifically if it's more niche. There are actually free cybersecurity meetups that are called B-Sides, and people usually give presentations. There might be demos, a networking session, and they're across many different cities in the US. And since many of us are virtual, a lot of them have also gone that route and hosted virtual events. So you don't have to go anywhere physically to actually attend these and take advantage of them. But they're great places to network. And after you get your foot in the door in your first cybersecurity career, the main way that people get new jobs is through friend to friend or connections, or basically people in their network. So I think networking, honestly, in any field that you go into, is one of the most important things. And it really is, like that quote goes, it's not what you know, it's who you know. All right, so that's it for this video. I know I crammed a whole bunch of different things into this topic, but I did want to give a holistic view of getting a job in cybersecurity. Honestly, so many companies are hiring, and so many people are really just moving around in their careers right now, whether they're in cybersecurity or not. So if you're looking for a new job or looking to make a career switch, this is the perfect time to do it. This is your year, and it's also a great way to expand your horizons and get out of your comfort zone. So please let me know in the comments below if you have any questions on getting a role in cybersecurity, entry-level careers, anything career related. I will be happy to answer. And if you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe and turn on post notifications. I post videos every Wednesday at 2 p.m. and Sundays at 12 p.m. And hopefully I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.